Now we have to go for characteristics. Now we have to go for characteristics of PN junction diode. Characteristics. Characteristics of PN junction diode. Characteristics of PN junction diode. What is the characteristics? Means that is a graph. Characteristics means it is a graph. You have to plot a graph. Where to where? The graph between voltage. The graph between voltage and current. The graph between voltage and current is called characteristics. If you apply the voltage, how current changes? We have to check in a graph. Before check the graph, you have to know what we have to know. In forward bias, in FB, forward bias, current is more. Current is more. In reverse bias, current is less. Current is more in forward bias. That's why in forward bias, current measures in milliampere. Milliampere. In reverse bias, current is less, very, very less. That's why current measures in microampere. Micro, 10 power of minus 6, very, very less value. So in forward bias, current is more. In milliampere, we have to take. In reverse bias, current is less. In microamperes, we have to take. In forward bias, we have to apply the voltage. That voltage is called forward voltage. In forward bias, applied voltage is called forward voltage. In reverse bias, applied voltage is called reverse voltage. Forward voltage, reverse voltage. Milliamperes, microamperes. Why micros are small amount of current? Why millis are more current? Okay, now I'm going to draw a graph. Where to where? Voltage versus current. I'm drawing a graph. This graph is very, very important. Okay, here I'm taking a y-axis. And I'm taking a x-axis. It is a x-axis. It is a y-axis, for example, right? On the x-axis, I'm taking voltage. Voltage on x-axis, current on y-axis. Same, it is also voltage on x-axis, current on y-axis. See, I'm drawing a graph for forward bias here. For forward bias, I'm choosing this part. For reverse bias, I'm drawing here. It is for reverse bias. You already know. In forward bias, how current measures? In forward bias, current measures in milliamperes. In reverse bias, current measures in microamperes. In forward bias, voltage is called forward voltage. In reverse bias, voltage is called reverse voltage. Okay. Now I am going to draw a graph. See, initially voltage is zero. For the battery, first time applied voltage is zero. Next, I am increasing 0.2 volts, 0.4 volts, 0.6 volts, 0.8 volts and 1 volt. Like that, I am increasing the voltage. Here, reverse bias. In reverse bias, we have to apply more voltage, not in 0.1, 0.2. We have to apply more voltage. That's why here I am taking, for example, 10 volts, 20 volts, 30 volts, 40, 50, 60, like that. Here I am taking the voltage. In forward bias, current is more. In milliampere, we are measuring, say, here it is a 10 milliamps, 20 milliamps, 30 milliamps, 40, like that. I have, I am taking current. In reverse bias, current is less, that is in microamps, say, it is a 10 microamp, 20 microamp, that's small current I am taking in reverse bias.